Teammates, this is your time. You have the power to go ahead.
I mean, aside from having to like stretch my brother out because he needs it at home, like I'll stand on his back because he's not flexible, guys. He lost it. What happened? I'm SMH. Anyways, I'm kidding, but not really. He's fun. We have fun with it. It's okay. And I'm sure he's fine with it too, because, you know, he's getting better at it as well. You know, we have a lot of fights at home, like fun fights, as in we'll grab each other's weapons and then fight each other with them, especially during trainings. If we're like having a hard time, he'll probably take his Eskrima sticks or whatever and whack me, or I'll whack him. Either way.
Okay. All right. So when Allison made Team USA, both 2020 and 2022, how'd you guys feel?
2020 was great.
I was happy for her.
We were happy for her. And it was also, for Allie, it was a recognition that she is good. And I think that was when she represented Pan Am.
Yeah, that she represented Team USA at the Pan American Online Championships. Mm-hmm. And that's the one, that's just the moment, that's the one that I always remember, because we found out she made the team, or was appointed to the team, before she did. And so we got to break the news to her, and she was speechless.
She was speechless. That's very rare for Allie. She always has something to say.
So just watching the smile emerge and how she reacted to that, and you can see, like, she started running around the front. She didn't know what to do with herself.
She just has so much energy.
Right. So I
typical Allie.
That's every parent's dream, to see their child like just feel like, yeah, just feel like they that joy, that authentic joy was wonderful to see.
I mean, another member of Elite Taekwondo, also a new member of CP, Kaden Okamoto. I've known him for way too many years.
How do you know Allison?
Allison has been like someone that I've known since when I very first started Taekwondo, like 9-ish years ago, 10-ish years ago. So yeah, she's been around for a while.
But even before we both joined CP or anything like that, we actually did a few talent shows together, both in elementary and in middle school.
What about those embarrassing talent shows you guys did?
Whoa, 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 whoa. Who says those were embarrassing, okay?
Oh, my bad.
Those were so good.
Bad.
So there's that. I looked back at them not too long ago and cringed really bad. But
you know, I have to play those now.
Oh no!
Your classmate over here just insulted me. I was so good at Taekwondo when I was in like the fifth grade. But you guys wouldn't know that. Unless he shows the videos, but please don't.
Insert here.
This one for the girls, say hallelujah, 'cause uptown funk don't get it to you.
But I mean, like, even though they were cringy, I still had fun with them. I mean, regardless of the cringy bits, you know, it's all in the past, and I'm sure not a lot of people remember, so it's okay.
Well, now more people will know.
When Allison first joined the CPV program, did you see her becoming a recognized Kumse athlete or a freestyle athlete?
When she first joined, she's recognized.
Recognized. I would say that at the time she joined the team, it was just primarily recognized. Freestyle Pumse was still around, but it didn't have the attention that it did during her time at MTeam, because they do a lot of demonstrations. She was learning skill sets that would easily transfer to freestyle. And then once freestyle started taking hold, and the minute she got her opportunity to do it for the first time, it was recognized, became sort of like, that's my second priority, because she really fell in love with freestyle. She's good at both, and the coaches still have her do both in competition to this day, mm-hmm. but her personal passion is towards freestyle because of the creativity, the ability to choreograph, the ability to do dynamic things, and it lets her utilize a lot of her natural athletic ability in doing flips and jumps and whatnot.
When Allison started competing at first, did you see her becoming more of a sparring competitor like you, or more of a Kumse competitor?
In the beginning, I think it could have gone either way for me, because at the beginning we all kind of saw her like really fast, and then we thought she could be a really quick kicker during matches. Her height thing, yeah, that was kind of a disadvantage, but I'm also fighting at a height disadvantage, and I also went into sparring route, so I could have saw her going into that same path as me. But at the same time, the amount of practice that we were both getting in Pumse, and how flexible she could have been, or she still is actually, but I could see her also going down the Pumse route. So honestly, it could have gone either way for me.
Yeah, like I think about for a lot of recreational
activities
for a lot of kids, because I coach soccer, and you know, I've been very involved in youth athletics. Sometimes it's sort of like, you know, kids go to practice, kids go to games, but they really don't practice the sport when they're at home. For Allison, she practices when she's at home. She practices when she's has to run errands with the family or parents. She's constantly figuring out a way to practice.
And she lives it.
Yeah, so we never have to worry about that.
What was the first couple of words that come to your mind when you hear Allison DeGuzman?
Usually it's like really good athlete. She's very it's very dedicated to Taekwondo. Sometimes she's a little bit quiet in her nature. She doesn't talk a lot unless you ask her something. But when she's close to you and when you're friends with her, she'll open up a little bit more.
So when I think of Allison, I think of her intensity. I think of her focus. I think of her never give up attitude. I think that she embodies the things that we teach her in Taekwondo with our indomitable spirit and perseverance.
Don't forget the principal acknowledgement of Ali in the sit-up. Or is it pull-up?
Yeah, the pull-ups. So the other thing was, like, I think Ali is, you know, Ali cares about fitness. I think that in elite Taekwondo, I remember Master Avila pointing out how Allison does push-ups correctly. She'd go all the way to the ground, and so she took pride in that, and I think that helped her in just developing and being very strong. Mm-hmm. You know, I remember when she was in middle school, she, you know, they would do those school fitness tests where you have to do push-ups and said how many push-ups or how many sit-ups in a minute, and Allison had the highest total of push-ups in the entire middle school, 6th, 7th, 8th grade across boys and girls. So the reality was she was just a very strong person, right? And because she just always constantly practicing and training. And even in our house, when we would do, like, let's just do pull-ups on our pull-up bar, I would do a number of pull-ups. I won't tell you how many. My son would do a number of pull-ups, and he would do about 12. Combined, we'd still have less than Ali, who was always 20-plus. She just was really, really strong.
I think definitely Ali and her dad helped me with a lot, especially in regards to not really just the like skill element and learning how to do all of the difficult elements, but it was more like the cultural aspect on how they judge a score and how other people compete and what exactly they prioritize or what they look for in a routine. So they really helped me get insight on what exactly I should be focusing on and how I should like train for certain to get the maximum amount of points in order to place higher. So they helped me a lot with that, but they also helped me with technique training, so all the elements were kind of improved by their knowledge.
Allison has a friend, she's really funny. I think she's someone you could depend on and like have fun jokes around with. Like, she is such a goofball when we all hang out. The funniest memory I have of her, and I'm pretty sure a lot of our friends can say it, but like we used to teach, so we went to like Great America twice, 2 years in a row, a while back, and we'd always tease her about how short she is and how she can't ride rides, and then she'd get a little mad about it. But it was a fun joke and good times we have with her.
But I think she's definitely a good friend, and if you ask her to do something, she's pretty reliable about doing that, unless she's sleeping. In which case, you kind of have to call her, but you know, it is how it is what it is.
I think the one of the funnier stories recently is when she decided to get my haircut. So, she needed a haircut. She went for a trim, but unfortunately, this was during COVID, so she had her mask on, and I guess our barber wasn't taking a close look at her. So she sat down, he propped her up, and I guess he thought she was me. So very first buzz cut, she just took off, I think, 70% of her hair in one go.
Wait, is that the reason why she had that short hair?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought she wanted it short.
Not that short.
Okay.
When she started Taekwondo, can you describe what she was like?
I was trying to think back. It's been a little while. So I think, as I remember, I just remember energy and a little fireball. I remember that she was always one of the loudest students in class. I remember that she was always very focused and intense, even at a young age. And I remember that she always gave her 100% to everything that she was doing.
The earliest memory I can recall with Allison was when we were getting ready for a winter recital at our Taekwondo way back like 7 years ago, I think. We were practicing for their performance, and I just remember she was the one who had to step on my back while other kids had to step on the other instructors, and we just had a really good time. Luckily, I wasn't the one getting injured though. It was someone else.
I remember one Halloween, it was in elementary school, probably like second or third grade. We both dressed up as Pokemon. I was Pikachu, and she dressed up as an Eevee for Halloween. I don't think it was planned, but we took a cool photo together, and that one is pretty funny because we're both really small. That one is pretty funny. And then a lot of her bloopers from M-Team bloopers from her falling, or the ones that she posts when she's practicing here, those are pretty funny, and sometimes I'm in those videos. You should insert one of those videos. Yeah.